Hi there. We're at the Global Legal Blockchain Consortium demo evening here in New York City, and my name is Aileen Schultz.
My name is Esther Dediashvili.
And we're on the road with Legal Talk Network. Thank you so much for joining us on the road in the Big Apple. Today, we're going to talk about the Global Legal Hackathon and Esther's involvement as a judge and actually as a host in the first round. So we'll just dive right in here. And Esther, why don't you tell us a bit about yourself?
Of course. Hi, very nice being here. Thanks for having me. So my name is Esther Dediashvili. I'm a legal knowledge manager and head of legal tech implementation at Fischer, Behar, Chen, Orion, and Co. And in short, FBC and Co. It's one of the largest law firms in Israel. And we have recently hosted the first legal hackathon in Israel, which was the first legal hackathon in the country. Together with us also, there were other co-hosts, Techlaw Israel, first legal tech platform in Israel. It was great collaborating, and the hackathon was an amazing and a huge success, attracting more than 100 participants. And we had leading judges, which were experts from legal and technology fields in Israel. So it was a huge success and really exceeded our expectations from the hackathon. I was also a judge at the first round, and it's been a huge honor to have been selected as the judge at the finals at the Global Legal Hackathon in New York, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Oh, well, yeah, we're looking forward to having you there. And so why don't you tell us a bit about why you in particular and why FBC and Co. Got involved in the hackathon in the first place?
FBC and Co. has longest standing and leading high tech practice in Israel. So we were very clear about that involvement in the hackathon would really help us to tap further into the local legal tech ecosystem, collaborate with other players in the field, and create some other new innovative solutions that would really help further legal service delivery in the country, which surprisingly, albeit known as a startup nation throughout the world, has been very behind in terms of legal tech development as opposed to other countries as US and maybe Europe. And we were hoping to boost and change this environment in terms of really raising awareness as to the benefits of technology within the legal industry. And the hackathon has recently really spurred interest in legal tech field. The hackathon locally has been showcased on so many channels in Israel, main financial channels as well, and really prompted discussions about what is legal technology, why should it be also used within a legal sphere. So Fischer Behar Chen has been involved in legal innovation for recent years, and my position is the only position in Israel for a legal knowledge manager who is also responsible for legal technology implementation. This in and of itself is innovation within the Israeli legal sphere. So being at the forefront of legal innovation was really important for FBC as a leader. And I think that hosting the country's first legal technology event and a hackathon was really a true testament to our commitment to be really bringing innovation to the local legal market.
Amazing. So you told us a bunch about locally the awareness building and the ecosystem building and the importance that you feel very strongly the legal innovation message has to bring to Israel. So what on a global scale do you think the importance of the Global Legal Hackathon is, both from the Israeli perspective, speaking globally, but then also just entirely on a universal level?
I think that in recent years, there's been much discussion about innovation in the legal industry, and it hasn't really resulted in tangible action on a global scale. And GLH has been really successful at moving the needle in terms of attaining real innovation in a very short period of time. pulling together so many legal and technology professionals from all over the world, 40 cities and 22 countries, if I'm not mistaken, across six continents, which is amazing. And it really was a testament of what a collaboration can do on a global scale. So I think that initiatives such as GLH are very important in raising awareness as to how can we, throughout this collaboration over a common objective of facilitating legal processes by leveraging technology, how can we find solutions, real working solutions to real world problems in the world, whether it's access to justice or private business of law. And I think that the GLH has been very illustrative of that, that it's possible that you can really, within a very short period of time, within 46 or 48 hours, you can actually have solutions that can be developed into something that really solves problems. In Israel, from Israeli perspective, one of the challenges in the country is a lack or a limited number of local solutions directed to Hebrew-speaking audiences. And throughout the competition and throughout the process, we really encouraged local participants to start generating solutions to directed to the Israeli legal market. I understand that there's only 9 million people who speak Hebrew in the world, which makes it less financial worthy to develop, you know, solutions for just the Hebrew speakers. But we were very excited to see that within 48 hours, many of the participants rose to the challenge and really developed both public and social benefit solutions specifically directed to the Hebrew public, and they can be adapted to English-speaking audience as well, but it was really important to see that it really came to life. It really had an impact. So I really hope that these solutions will really come to life, and that GLH has opened a door and marked a new chapter in the history of legal industry, definitely started a movement, and we're really proud to be a part of it.
Yeah, and I mean, hey, everyone is glad to have you as part of it. So
thank you.
Perfectly mutual. And yeah, so we were talking a bit before this about how FBC and Co. and yourself, how you're working with the teams to actually progress beyond. So beyond even just the finalists or, you know, locally, the teams that did really well, you're working with a couple teams that are actually continuing with their solutions. I'm not going to drop the spoilers here, so I'm going to let you talk a bit more about that, because that's pretty incredible.
Right. So one of the things about hackathons that usually happens a lot is that they fizzle. And afterwards, there's no communication with the participants. And we thought that this would be just missing an opportunity to really get the momentum and really push this industry towards development. So after the hackathon, right after it, actually, we had meetings at the FBC and Co. with the high-tech partners of the firm, which shows you the importance that they attribute to this initiative, with all the teams who wanted to have guidance and receive legal guidance or technology guidance. And we really want to help them find exposure to investors. So we're working on a follow-up event where we can gather everyone, see how much progress and traction they have been able to attain within this short period of time, over 2 months, and perhaps have them meet other investors who will be interested in pursuing this further, because I think that that's what they're lacking at this point of time, especially in the beginning.
Yeah, and you mentioned something specifically with regard to, I'm asking a very leading question here. So you mentioned something specifically about the Ministry of Justice, and that was pretty phenomenal. So I'm going to ask if you can highlight that a bit.
I'd love to. One of the surprising and really thrilling experiences for us was for the Ministry of Justice in Israel to really support the entire hackathon locally, and also the general director of the Ministry of Justice. She chaired a specific panel, which was directed, it was in addition to the main panel, it was directed to the public benefit solutions, and they awarded a special prize for the best solution, which promoted public benefit and access to justice. And the winning team, along with other teams, have been invited to present their solutions in front of leading technologists of the Ministry of Justice, which are potentially going to be a client. So adopting the solution countrywide, which is really amazing, and the support that they gave us was really, we were blown away by it.
We all are.
Didn't expect it at all.
Yeah, that's an incredible story. Yeah, so thank you so much for sharing that with the audience. And so you were a judge in the first round at FBC & Co., and now you're going to be a judge in the final round of the Global Legal Hackathon. So this is where we're going to determine, you know, who the winners are of the entire thing. So can you tell us a bit about, first, your judging experience locally, but then also what you're anticipating going into the final rounds, and how you might look at things differently or assess the teams differently, and what exactly you're looking for?
Thank you for that question. I do have an experience from the first round, from the Israeli round, as a judge, and it definitely gives me a little bit of a preview of what is going to happen. Each team will probably have a certain amount of time to present their solution and for judges to be able to give feedback and questions, which I'm sure is going to be very exciting. I do have also an experience in being involved at Mass Challenge Accelerator, which is a very worldwide Israeli exposure-wise known initiative, and I am a judge there as well. So I do have an experience in that field as well. It's not specifically directed to the legal sphere. It's all kinds of startups. So it definitely gives you a broader range in terms of what to look for. I think that in broad terms, what I would be looking for is what is the team or the solution that will have potentially the biggest impact in the legal industry. Doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be public access to justice or private benefit. It could be any type of solution, and which one of them has the most credible and believable path to that impact, considering traction and considering the progress that the teams have made. This is in broad terms, and specifically, well, I'm sure that everyone is already aware of criteria. Main criteria are user validation in terms of, it's really important to know what is your target audience and what their needs are. For example, if you have a solution that is directed to lawyers in general, it's important to understand that lawyers have different specifications. One solution that is directed to an attorney in the litigation doesn't necessarily fit the needs of a corporate lawyer. So it's important to know who you're addressing and have their feedback really adjusted within your solution. That's one thing. Another one is design, clean design, user friendliness, how much easy it is to navigate the solution. If you have a great idea, which is hard to implement and hard to use, then you're basically missing the opportunity. And the last one is the business model, of course, showing real value as opposed to competitors, that you've done your research, you have a credible scalability and customer acquisition plan, and as a bonus, presenting an ROI to investors, prospective investors. So I will definitely be addressing those criteria. And I think that I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all 14 teams for being at this point and participating in the biggest legal innovation event on the planet right now. I think that they should be very proud, and just being part of this whole initiative is making them winners already. So good luck tomorrow.
Yeah, amen to that. Yeah, so we're here at the Global Legal Blockchain Consortium demo evening, and there's been some recent news regarding FBC & Co. and the GLBC. You guys recently jumped on board with the consortium, and that is a huge deal, I imagine, both in Israel, as well as, I mean, just for the industry, that's incredible, and a testament to the use of blockchain in law. So why don't you tell us a little bit about why FBC & Co. Jumped on board with the consortium?
Thank you. Great question. We're very excited to be joining the GLBC initiative, along with other leading law firms internationally, including Fasken, Denton's in Canada, and other technology giants like IBM, and of course Integra, who is behind the Global Legal Hackathon. It's a great opportunity to collaborate with leading players in this field, including academia members like Suffolk University. We really feel very connected to being at the forefront as a firm, at the forefront of innovation. And I think that emerging technologies such as AI, blockchain, 3D printing, and so forth, IoT, they're really on the verge of changing industries and transforming so many industries, including legal industry. So being at their tipping point, we really want to be part of this. We want to find real applications of the blockchain technology within the legal sphere, and specifically within the local legal framework in Israel. So being part of this initiative is also a illustration, and it's really important to the firm to be at the forefront of innovation. And it's a great opportunity to collaborate, as I already mentioned, on such a wide and broad range of applications. So being here at the demo night is really interesting for me specifically, just to see what other law firms and other players have been able to come up with and get ideas, get other developments in this field. So thank you for asking the question. We're really proud to join the GLBC.
Yeah, well, hey, thanks for jumping on board and joining the conversation. So one final question then today before we close here. You've told us a lot of amazing things. You're up to incredible things in Israel and in the industry at large, and you're a force of nature. We all know this. So people who want to get connected with you and all of that, how can they reach you?
Thank you. I would love to be contacted by anyone who's interested in legal tech in Israel and in knowledge management. You can contact me via email, esterd@fbclawyers.com, or via the website of www.fbclawyers.com, or you can just message me on LinkedIn.
Great. Well, we've reached the end of the road of today's episode. So thank you so much, Esther, for joining us here in New York for this event. And thank you to all of Legal Talk Network's listeners as well for tuning in and hearing more about what Esther has to share with us. And please jump on, if you've enjoyed what you've heard today, please jump on Apple Podcasts and give a solid rating. And we'll see you next time for another episode of On the Road with Legal Talk Network.
If you'd like more information about what you've heard today, please visit LegalTalkNetwork.com. Subscribe via iTunes and RSS. Find us on Twitter and Facebook, or download our free Legal Talk Network app in Google Play and iTunes. The views expressed by the participants of this program are their own and do not represent the views of, nor are they endorsed by, Legal Talk Network, its officers, directors, employees, agents, representatives, shareholders, and subsidiaries. None of the content should be considered legal advice. As always, consult a lawyer.